Welcome back, my beautiful diamonds, or welcome. It's me, Nessa, and this is my makeup nook. And that is exactly what it is, a makeup nook that sits at the end of my hallway. So you're gonna hear traffic. You're gonna hear my little prince who sits in the dining room hanging out doing his video games, and you're gonna hear my king over in the man cave playing his video games, and my little princess, my little fur baby, as she runs around the house. Today I asked the question, to prime or not to prime? I primed one eyelid for before shadow, and I did not prime the other. If you're as curious about that question as I am, if you need to prime or not to prime, how about you grab yourself a bevy, sit right there, and I'll answer that question for you. All right, my beautiful darlings, let me tell you what I did for my face today. To moisturize and prime, I used my Summer Fridays Jet Lag Mask we got in BoxyCharm in January. For foundation, I used L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Infallible in the shade 201. Under my eyes, I did ColourPop's Pretty Fresh Concealer in the shade Fair 7C. To set down my under eyes, I used e.l.f. Prime Prep and Prime Powder in the shade Fair Light. I used my Fenty Beauty Pro Filter setting powder in the shade Lavender, also in BoxyCharm for January. For bronzer, I used the Rimmel Natural Bronzer in the shade 021 Sunlight. Excuse me. For my blush, I used NARS Orgasm. It's a mini. She's super cute. And for the highlighter, my tried and true, my favorite one of all times, is Oprah Glazed Donut. I also received her in BoxyCharm. Super pretty. For my brows, I used my Milani Stay Put Brows in the shade 04. For my waterline, I used ColourPop's BFF Gel Liner in the shade Catsuit. To do my wing liner, I used my little mini KVD Tattoo Liner to do my wings. For my lashes, I used my Ruby Maze Lashes Style Jackie. Super pretty, winged out lashes. Of course, to put my lashes on, I glued them down with a Kiss adhesive glue. Should have known it, in the shade Red, 10 Red. Super pretty. So, how about we pull back the bangs and zoom you in and get you all up and close and personal. And I'm a little late in the game, but I finally got my hearts up. Yay, for the month of love. Beautiful darling, so to expose much foreheads blessed to me by my father, let's zoom you in and get up close and personal. All right, so now you're up close and personal. come on in. So, to prime or not to prime, that is the question. So today we are going to prime my left eye with my e.l.f. putty primer in the shade Rose. She's about $5. And I'm going to leave my right eye completely naked. Completely naked. This way it will show what the difference is. Show you how the shadows look with or without primer. So today's look, I used my Raw Beauty Christie Pure collab with Raw Beauty Christie. Or Raw Beauty Christie's collab with Pure. And I used the colorful side today. Okay, we are going to take my little concealer brush and pop in and prime my left eye. So you're gonna pop up on a mirror and you're just going to brush that all over your eye. Okay. Just like that. Now, gonna leave the right eye naked. Get out your handy dandy color switch and your Bundy brush. This one is the M503, just a little Berlin brush. Color switch him off. And I'm going to go in with Tribute. And I'm gonna put her in the corner of my eye. Okay? You pop into it, put it on the end of the, tap it off. And we're gonna put it in right here. Okay, just tap it right in there. We're gonna use about 3 taps of this. Just get it in that little corner right there. Okay, tap it again, and put it in there. Okay, switch it out this side.
Okay, that is the second tap in. Okay, see how vibrant that is? All right, so one more time, just to kind of get it down into this little crevice in here, into my little corner, and back out. I'm gonna kind of buff out the edge a little bit, just like that. So that was three dips knit, and that's the color we got. Okay, we're gonna do three dips on the other side and see if the pigment's there. I'm gonna tap into the corner of the eye. There is one and two. Okay. And three. Okay. And you see how this side's darker? It's more pigmented, it's more prominent, it's out there. And this one's kind of more subdued, more watercolorish and pastel. You could build up this side and get it to look like this. But why should you if you just use primer and get primer on there and get that color payoff that you're looking for? Okay, this is a pretty look too. If this is what you're into, you go, girl. You get it, darling. But you know, primer does it does what it's supposed to do and make it brilliant and vibrant and pretty and in your face. Okay, so we're going to take our handy dandy little color switched same brush. We are going to go into the color Garden State. We're going to tap into Garden State and we're going to tap him right into that purple and blend him into it and out towards that outer V. That was just half one. Just kind of smeared into, blended into the purple. Okay. Not too much payoff there. We're going to tap into him again. And we're going to just tap him in there just like that. One more time, just as we can, just to kind of get the pigment that I want it to be. And okay, see how the pigment is just awesome. A little bit of fall. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side and see how this green stands up with no primer. So right into that purple, and blend it out, all the way up. Get the first color down, see how it's not as pigmented as the first time in. So we're gonna go two. All right, gives a little bit more payoff, just a little. And my theory is too, is if I'm going to spend money on a palette, paying for is the color and the pigment and the, you know, the blendability of it, and I want it to be beautiful. But see how that one is just kind of muted? Just kind of not really, this one's so much darker and vibrant, and this one's just pastel and kind of washed out. Primer. To prime or not to prime? That is the question. And then I went into Flavor Town. Okay. And I put Flavor Town on my outer V out here. Okay. So I bumped it into that Garden State and I drag it out to the outer V. Now, could I do a little bit more finessing on this look? Absolutely. And I would have if we're not trying to prove a point. We are trying to prove a point. So that Flavor Town right on out there. That was my second tap into it. Set it right down into that little pocket out there. And one more time. And this time I'm going to pop it in there and I'm going to drag it up over that green and towards that purple, just to kind of blend out that edge there. Okay, same thing other side, Flavor Town, into this outer corner. We're gonna tap into that green. I'm just gonna kind of put that color out there. It's just not pigmented enough. Just doesn't got the bloop, the oomph that it needs to have. Just tap it out there. See, it doesn't really even pay off. And the third time, tap into it, and we're gonna drag it up over that look. Color, oranges and yellows are a hard color to pigment and put on an eye. That is why we are going to color switch once again, and I'm going to go into the color Dandelion, a yellow. So we're going to go into Dandelion, just like that, and I'm going to go into Flavor Town right up here, and I'm going to blend it into and over that purple down into the corner of my eye, okay? Keep in mind color theory is also involved. You're going to be over that purple. It's going to change that yellow from pure yellow into a darker kind of mustardy yellow because of the colors that you're mixing with it. Remember, color theory is important when you're mixing makeup, but see how it's there, okay? It's there. See that yellow there and then down in here? One more time just to make that pigment happen. I'm going to go right down in here with it and go back up towards it. Same thing, other side, just to see if that yellow pays off. So we're going to go right into that orange and we're going to go towards my nose and down. And see how it just does not get there? And it's not the palette. It's the primer. It's the primer. This is the same palette. It's the primer doesn't give it a chance to do its live up to its biggest potential. And that's the second coat. It's still pretty. It's still a very beautiful color. It's just not. Just not its full potential. Oh, still a beautiful little look, but just not the true, pure, raw beauty Christy experience. So, while we're here, we might as well put on a lash because that is what we do and we do best. So, I'm gonna go put on my under eye color. Believe it or not, it is not black. It is the color Catsuit by Color. And off camera, I'm gonna put this on real quick. All right, perfect. We're gonna call the palette good to go. I'm gonna go into the mid-level torture device. And my handy dandy dollar store mascara. I'm going to curl lashes. Oh, she's not seeing. Really tricky to get your lash thinner. Okay, so I'm just gonna do a really light coat of mascara just to get them to match my lashes. Because we're getting ready to put on a set of lashes, of course. Alright, so I'm gonna take their real by Benefit. I'm gonna do that on the under eye. These are the lashes I picked today. I'm gonna do one at a time because I'm gonna do a winged liner, and doing a winged liner takes a little bit more time. Yeah. You're gonna take your handy dandy felt tip liner. This was is the KVD tattoo liner in a mini. It's just a mini. Happy, happy. It's felt tip. And you're gonna do a wing. You don't have to, but you can. So I'm gonna do a wing with you. Do not panic, do not freak out. Wings are not complicated. You just gotta take a deep breath, let it go, and just go with it. So we're gonna tap it down here in the bottom of my lash, the top lash, my eyelid, my top lash, and you're gonna tap it right there, and you're gonna just flick it out. Just like that. Okay. I'm going to tap the end of this felt tip to the end of the line, just like this, and drag it back in. Okay, see how it made that beautiful little thing? I'm going to hold out here, flatten it out, and color it in. So, just like this. It's kind of a thick one today, so we're just going to take a minute. Oops, not get too far carried away with it. Sometimes they're skinny little wings, sometimes they're thick wings. Do not be afraid of a wing. It is just makeup. If you do not like it, you can wipe it off. Now, mind you, you have to start all over the look, but you can wipe it off. So I did kind of mess up on my eyeshadow up there. See, it's messed up there? Watch this. I rest my eyes, and it pretty much goes away. So. You just want this. So then I take the tip of the felt tip and I go to the end of the line and I just flick it out. Just like that. Okay? Just kind of color it in. And then I'm going to go to the interior of my nose. I'm going to draw that out there just like that. Color it in. Okay. I am not a professional when it comes to wing liner. Not at all. Not even in the littlest of bits. So I'm going to do the first little lash with you, and then we're going to go off camera, and I'm going to do the next liner and lash. So you're going to wiggle, 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 wiggle this little guy. Grab the little lash like so. You're going to get down on your mirror like this. You're going to look at it, and you're going to place that lash as close to that lash line as you can get it, of course. Tuck the end. Don't get it into your eye. I've done that before. It hurts. Okay. Tuck, tuck, tuck. Tuck, tuck, tuck. And just like that, your lash is up. Okay? Now, I'm going to do that other one off camera, and I will be right back. All right. Just like that. Lashes are up. Okay. Let's do the lip. You know me and a classic red lip. Gotta love it. Okay, so let's pull down the bangs. Fluff the bangage. Doop doop doop, makes it all make sense. Just like that. Let's do a set. This is just a little baby all nighter, up all nighter, right up in the cage. From the wonderful wall of wonders. Wonderful wall of wonders. The fancy fun. That makes me feel so special. And just like that, my beautiful darlings, we are done. Done! To prime? Or not to prime? That, my beautiful darlings, is the question. I do appreciate y'all coming in and hanging out with me. And if you by chance have made it this far, do me a favor and speak to me, my beautiful darlings. I would love to hear from you. Tell me if this is some content that you would really like to see more of. I'm an open little book. I want to experience this YouTube experience with you. So please comment. Please talk to me. And I'm going to start something a little new this time around. I'm going to give you an inspirational beauty quote. So today's is, be your own kind of beautiful. On that beautiful little saying, my loves, my beautiful darlings, I'm going to let you go with much love. Much love, and I will see you very, very soon. Thank you for popping in.